temperature will get it up to 70, right? Okay, so 71. What is the maximum concentration of equimolar solution of ferrous sulfate and sodium sulfate? So that when mixture mixed in equal volume, there is no precipitate of iron sulfur. Right? Now here the question is asked to us. The two different solutions when they are mixed, precipitate should not occur. Then what should be the concentration of those two solutions? In the last lecture, when we did the previous sum, what was it showing? Whether it will precipitate or not. When we derived that question, what we saw it? Whether it will precipitate or not. Right? Here what we want to do it is, we want to find out the concentration so that precipitation does not occur. Right? So for that case, which are the two solutions that I give it? Ferrous sulfate. First one, it will be producing it as an Fe plus 2 SO4 minus 2. Right? Then the second one is given out as sodium sulfide Na2S. It will act as itself as twice Na plus S minus 2. Right? Equal volumes are mixed. Quantity of the volume is equal. Concentration is also equal. Solution, the concentration, equimolar, right? The what is used? So same volume, same concentration. We want it as the third component that should be precipitated is iron sulfide, FeS. That means we want it as Fe plus 2, S minus 2. We want it as Fe plus 2 and S minus 2. Okay? Now, using this, what we want to find out, what is the concentration of these two solutions? Right? What is the concentration of these two solutions? And the factor that is given to us, KSP of FeS, 6.3 into 10 raised to minus 18. Okay? Only five value is given to us, KSP. Now what to do? What we are aware about it is, if IP is equals to KSP, if IP is equals to KSP, we know that it's an in equilibrium. At the same time, no precipitate will occur. Respirator occurrence takes place only and only if the condition is having IP greater than KSP. Right? So, if IP is taken equals to KSP, there won't be any respirator. Can I take this IP as KSP as IP? So that from this, I will find out the concentration of Fe plus 2 and S minus 2. We'll find out the concentration of Fe plus 2 and S minus 2. So putting it as an IP equals to KSP. IP will be 6.3 into 10 raised to minus 18. And that will be equals to, you will be having it as an Fe plus 2 S minus 2. When we want to find out the IP, Fe plus 2 exponential is 1. S minus 2, again exponential is 1, right? So we will be adding it as an IP equals to S square under root IT 6.3 into 10 raised to minus 18. This is already an even number, so I can go for it directly as a square root. And 6.3, square root of 6.3
is 1.50.
2.50. Okay, so we got it as an IP as solubility, which we are writing it over here 2.50 10 raised to minus 9. This is also 2.50 into 10 raised to minus 9. This is Fe plus 2 and S minus 2 that you got it. Right? Okay, now we already did it. Again, if I want to go it for the concentration of x minus 2 or f plus 2, we calculated it from this in the previous term. M1 V1 equals to M2 V2. Right? Here what we'll do it is again using the same value. But this time we will take this as an M1 and V1 will become as total volume, because two solutions are mixed together. Right? So can I go it for the formula? M1 V1 equals to M2 V2. This is 2.5 Newton raised to minus 9. 2V, that equals to M2 into the volume V2, right? So what will you get it? M2 equals to 5 into 10 raised to minus 9. That is the same value is there for it. Okay, now from this reaction, we also studied it. Whatever the concentration is there, it gets analyzed. We consider it. If this is 1 molar, this is 1 molar. Right? So now, if this is 5 into 10 to the minus 9, what should be its concentration? 5 into. Similarly, here it also shows it. The same condition as this also. So, what should be the concentration of the solution so that precedent won't occur? This should be the concentration of the solution. Right? In the previous sum, what we did it? From here we started. Here the reaction, this numerical is completing the reverse process. Okay? Is it clear? Clear to everyone? See, you are saying it already as an answer. The moment I am going to complete the rest, you are going to give you additional numericals which you will be doing it by yourself. Right? So make it sure that before you say yes, think it twice and then reply. Okay, next one. What is the minimum volume of the water required to dissolve 1 gram of calcium sulfide at 293 Kelvin? For calcium sulfide, KSV is given to us 9.1 newton raised to minus 6. Calcium sulfide means CaSO4, right? It will be analyzing it itself into Ca plus 2. SO4 minus 2. Right? So what we are going to get it? KSP is equals to S square, or S is equals to under root KSP. Okay? This is going to give me solubility. Solubility means in the terms of molarity. This is going to get the value in the terms of molarity. Now KSP is given to us 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 6. Again, this is even number.
3.01 into 10 raised to minus
3. 3.01 into 10 raised to minus 3. This is the solubility in the terms of molarity. But the question has to be, what is the minimum amount of the water required for making solubility of 1 gram of calcium sulfate? We want to dissolve only 1 gram of calcium sulfate. What does it show? This much moles is dissolved in 1 liter. The value at present we got it is this much amount of the moles it is dissolved in 1 liter. Right? We want to find out the volume for 1 gram. So what to do it? From the first chapter we will have to use the formula of molarity. Right? The formula of the molarity we know it as rate of solute 1000 molar mass into volume in ml. This is the value we already got it. 3.01 into 10 raised to minus 3. Rate of the solute given to us. How much I want to dissolve? I want to dissolve only 1 gram. It's already given to me. Right? Whatever the mass is told to us, listen. 1000 molar mass of calcium sulfate. Calcium 40, sulfur 32, oxygen 64. So totally you are going to get it as 136. Totally you are going to get it as 136. That is the molar mass. So we got it that value also. And we want to find out volume in energy. So making it as a subject. The answer you are going to get it in the terms of energy. Total volume is 15 ml because 10 ml of S minus 2 was taken, and 5 ml of FeHO4 is heating. Right? So for this we will be getting it as 1 into temperature minus 10 into 10 by 15. And for this we will be getting it as 0.04 into 5 by 15. Okay, that are the concentrations that you will be getting it. M1, B1, B2. We will get it M2. Right? Okay. On simplification, I am going to write this as 0.04 by 3, 2 into 10 to the minus 10 by 3.
0.01.
Okay, whatever it will be. Now, what I want to do is, I want to calculate it. IP, Fe plus 2, S minus 2, it's 0.04, 2 into 10 to the minus 10. Right? What is the answer we are going to get for this? 8 into 10 to the minus 12 by 9. Right? 0.9 something you will be getting. 0.9 approximately of getting it. Right? I am writing the approximately.
Yes, sir.
0.9 into 10 to the minus 12. Right? This is your IP. Can I write it as 9 into 10 to the minus
13? Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, but at the same time, now using the table in your textbook, the table is given to us. In exam, the value will be given to us for the KSP of FES. Find out your table 229. You have been given FES 6.3 into 10 to the minus 18. KSP is 6.3 into 10 to the minus 18. What will be the condition? IP greater than or less than? What is the condition? IP value I got it. KSP is there. IP is greater than KSP or IP is less than KSP? IP will be greater than. So because IP is greater than KSP, precipitate of FES will work out. Right? So this is one by using FES so forth. Right? The second part of the numerical that is given to you, that is by using MnCl2. You have to use it second time. In place of FeHO4, it's a MnCl2. Ionization will change. Mn plus 2, 2Cl minus. 2Cl minus, so this molar will be multiplied by 2. Right? Okay. We want to check that whether MnS will precipitate or not. The question says that want to check whether sweet sulfide will be precipitate or not. Right? So what we are going to do here? Mn plus 2, S minus 2. Right? This value is not going to change. This value is also not going to change. The values are going to remain same. Right, that means once you get this, only the thing to change is the formula of the component. But at the same time, my KSP of MnS is different. As per the table, the KSP value
2.5
10 raised to minus
13.
But
now, IP is greater than or less than KSP?
Greater.
IP is?
Greater than.
Sure.
Sure, sure.
Both of them are 10 raised to minus 13.
9 per
9 per 9.
Fine.
9.
Right? So every time, this will not, the factor is going to be checked. Even a small price also makes the precipitate to occur. Okay? Similarly, S2 are given, ZnCl2 or CdCl2. Their KSPs are also given in the book. आपको याद नहीं करने पहले दे दी होगी, मैंने पहले ही कह दी। अभी आपके पास बुक के न्यूमेरिकल कर रहे हो, इसीलिए बुक में से देखो वो दिया है। एग्जाम में के एस पी की वैल्यू लिख दी थी, ठीक है? बोलो, समझ में आ गया?
यस।
हाँ, क्लियर हो गया? ओके, एनी ऑफ द डाउट रिलेटेड टू एनी ऑफ द न्यूमेरिकल बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू कंप्लीट द चैप्टर। I'm going to complete the chapter. Right? Any questions? If nothing is there, write down the question. Now you write down the numerical part of it.
Okay.
What is the amount of? What is the amount of sulfuric acid? What is the amount of sulfuric acid required to be added in barium chloride solution? Barium chloride solution whose concentration is 0.05 molar and volume is 10 ml. Volume is 10 ml, 0.05 molar, 10 ml. And what is the amount of the sulfuric acid required so that precipitate occurs, so that in the reaction precipitate occurs. Okay, precipitation should occur. See, again I am saying, repeating it. You have been asked, what is the quantity of H2SO4 required? Okay, now see the word here, it's going to be very important. I did not ask what is the volume. The question is, what is the amount? That means you want to answer it in the terms of grams. आपको आंसर किस में लाना पड़ेगा? Grams, right? When we are using H2SO4, it's a volume, right? Concentration, what we find out, it's a moles dissolved in a liter. So I'm going to add one more step. So the two numericals that we did it today, I have combined together. दो numericals जो आज किए उन दोनों को मिक्स कर दिया, एक में मोलारिटी करके ग्राम्स को डिसॉल्व करके वॉल्यूम निकाला था, थोड़ा सा चेंज किया, वॉल्यूम निकाल के ग्राम्स में कन्वर्ट कर दिया, ठीक है? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल 2H प्लस SO4 माइनस 2, वी आर गोइंग टू यूज इट एज एन BaCl2, Ba प्लस 2, 2Cl माइनस, द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ दिस इज गिवन टू यू 0.05. That means this one will be 0.05. Okay? And the volume is also given to you. 10 ml. Volume is also given to us. 10 ml. Okay? For this also, we will consider that we are taking it as an 10 ml. Okay? We want to make it as an BaSO4 to precipitate. What should happen? BaSO4 should be precipitated. That means Ba plus 2, SO4 minus 2. Ba value we can get it. We will get the value of Ba. We will be getting it as M1. V1 divided by V2. Okay, we will get it as Ba plus 2. Again, from the textbook, as we are having in the textbook, the value is not given to you in the numerical, it's given KSP of BaSO4. Yes, please give it. Again, this time I'm considering it that I is equals to ESP. Solution will be in equilibrium. Right? If slight more concentration is taken, what will happen? IP will become greater than ESP. Right? So at present what I am doing it is IP equals to, I'm considering it like that. So what will get it? IP equals to BA plus 2 SO4 minus 2. This value we got it as 1 into 10 raised to minus 10. BA we got it 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2. SO4 we want to find out. Okay. Now what will happen? We can get it as we'll get the value of SO4.
Okay. 6.5.